Hey, what's up, Fendlings? It's Fendlings here, and welcome to another mod showcase. And today, we're going to look at the progressive automation mod by VanHell. This mod was actually made for the Mod Jam 4. It's just new. I think there's only one video of it, which is made by the developer himself. And this is a pretty nifty mod that I really wanted to show you guys, and it's a typical example of a mod that gets more expensive through, like, when you get higher in the stuff. So I'm going to show you right now what it does. Basically, you will get some sort of device slash machine, which are called miners. And you basically place them down and it will start mining for you, which is pretty straightforward. Now, there's one thing that you need to start off with, and that is a wooden miner. That's the first thing that you can make, and you only basically need 6 logs, doesn't matter which kind of logs, 1 chest, a furnace, and a wooden pickaxe in this pattern. And you will get a wooden miner. Now, if we take this wooden miner, we can, of course, place it down and use it. And I will show you really soon how you actually use it. But you can also upgrade it. And that's what I'm going to do right now. Because we can also upgrade it to a stone miner, iron miner, and a diamond miner. Now, to upgrade it to a stone miner, you basically have 7 cooked stone. I don't think it works with cobblestone. And you put the wooden miner in the middle. And a stone pickaxe, and then you get a stone miner. Now, if you want to go for iron, it's basically the same idea, and you just replace the stone with iron ingots. You put a iron pickaxe in there, and the stone miner, and you get a iron miner. And the same with diamonds. Now, as you might have seen, for every different miner, you basically have to put the pickaxe in there, which is that material. So you start with a wooden pickaxe, then you get a stone pickaxe, whoopsie daisy, a stone pickaxe, an iron pickaxe, and a diamond pickaxe. Now let's just take for example the iron miner. Let's not take diamond miner. We're gonna put it down. Now we're going to open the interface, and it says not ready, need fuel, and the range is 1. And there's a lot of different things here that we can actually do. And I will show you what you can do with them. But first, you can also upgrade these nifty little machines. And how you upgrade them is with wooden, stone, iron, and diamond upgrades. Now, a wooden upgrade you made with 1 redstone and 8 wooden planks. And you'll get a wooden upgrade. And the upgrading system goes the same again. You take the wooden and you put it right in the middle there. And you get a stone upgrade. Then we take the stone upgrade and put it in the middle there. Replace the stone with iron, and you get an iron upgrade, and the same with the diamonds. Now, every sort of upgrade works only on the specific miner with the same material. So you can use a stone upgrade on a stone miner, diamond upgrade on a diamond miner. That's not that difficult, right? Okay, let's I put down a stone miner, so let me take a stone upgrade. Or actually, I have this chest filled with that stuff. See? Oh my god, look at that preparation, you guys. Look at that. So we're gonna take all this stuff. Because I will need it for my beautiful explanation. And I will get this. And we already put a stone miner in there. The difference between the wooden, stone, iron, and diamond miner is that you will have the opportunity to mine more things. And I also think it goes faster. So let's open the user interface of this miner. Now there's a lot of things here, and I will explain one by one what these all do. This is basically the place where you put your cobblestone. Why would you put cobblestone in there, you might ask? Well, it's really simple. This miner solves the problem that you have with other mods like minions that they just mine, and you have this ugly open mine slash chunk with all cutaway stuff, and you have tons of cobblestone you cannot do anything with. Basically, what this does is it cuts or it digs up everything, all the cobblestone, everything that's under it, and it replaces it with cobblestone. So you won't have any empty spaces in your mine, which is really, really cool. And that's actually a really nice solution for that problem. Down here, you have a little coal iron. This can be anything that is sufficient as fuel for a normal furnace. In this case, I'm going to use wooden planks. You can, of course, also use coal. Now it says, not ready, need a pickaxe. And we're going to put a pickaxe in here. And since it's a stone miner, we're going to put a stone pickaxe in there. And now it needs a shovel. So we're also going to put the shovel in. Because for the dirt, it's going to use the shovel. And it's actually already starting. Look at that. So basically, there's 86... 68 blocks directly under the miner, and it's going to cut those all away. Currently, it's getting a lot of stone. It got 3 dirt and 5 gravel. And basically, what it does now, if it has, like for example, if it dug up these, it will replace it with cobblestone. If it mines cobblestone, it will replace that like right back. So that's really awesome. So basically, you would only more or less need one stack here, unless your whole, basically everything below the miner is made out of dirt. Then that wouldn't work, of course. Now, this is cool because it's done now. It stopped using fuel. And we actually got this in here. So, what can we do now? We can either move this away. And you can see it drops everything that's inside. And there's like all cobblestone down there. So, that actually worked. Now, what we can also do is we want something like a bigger area to mine, because this is only one block and this is going to take a long, long time. So we can put it down and we're going to put effort. Now I will put coal in, doesn't really matter. We need our cobblestone, of course. We need a stone pickaxe and a shovel. I'm actually not going to put it in yet because I want to put an upgrade in. And what do these upgrades do? These upgrades basically extend the range. Now the range is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9. For example, let's put it on 9. So now basically the range will be all these blocks around. They will all one by one because it goes vertically. So first it will probably do like this block and then we'll go all the way down 68 blocks. Then it will do this one, etc, etc, etc. Now you can do this, for example, with a whole stack. Now the range is 65. But it keeps getting better because you can also put another stack in. Now it has 129. So you can basically do this. I think, I don't know if there's any cap. I don't think so. There probably is somewhere. But for now there isn't. And if you would destroy it, it also gives you those upgrades back. So if you were going to upgrade your miner, you still get your upgrades back and you can convert them, for example, into iron ones. So let's put this down again, put everything in. And let's make it start mining with a lot of upgrades. So now as you can see, now it's going to do way more blocks. You can just stay here and, you know, wait. Let me see where it starts now. Look, here's where it started. And it's probably going that way or that way. I don't know. One of those two ways. So what happens if you run out of fuel, you might ask? Well, that's really simple. I don't think I can show you right now. But what happens if it would mine up some coal and you're out of fuel, that coal will go directly back into the fuel, which is really, really cool. Now, there's some more things we can do here besides all the upgrading. We can put a chest on top. What would you do that for? Well, basically, it will output everything that the miner gets and it will output it in a chest, which is, of course, really handy. But also these stone pickaxes have durability. And I'm actually kind of waiting for this one to run out. Let's wait for that. There we go. Now it needs a pickaxe and it will just stop. So how do we prevent that? Well, that's pretty simple. We just take a hopper and we connect it right to the miner. And we put a... we open this thing. And for example, we put a new stone pickaxe, which I don't have a stone pickaxe. And we put it right in there. And it will automatically go back into our miner. So that's pretty handy. And look, they already start on the second one and this will go on forever. And you will get all the ores that it finds in here. Now, in this case, we have a stone pickaxe. So only the iron that it finds and the coal that it finds, it will end up here. But what if we want to mine diamonds? Well, that's really easy. Then you will just need a iron miner if you want some iron upgrades. And then you will be able to mine the diamonds, otherwise you won't. So that's pretty clear, I guess. And there's really not much to it. So this was for the Mod Gem 4. I think there's a lot of upgrades coming. I think this is a really cool idea. And I really hope he continues developing this. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, please leave a like on this video, show some support. And I really hope to see you in my next mod review!